guys and Bill to do the auto work for us while I was here.
Yeah, got the Jeep running. Got Betsy Jeep running pretty decent.
Got the lawnmower running, got the Jeep running. Yeah. Got the bus engine running.
Penetration in it. I can feel it going down in there.
Is that what you said?
Yeah. I can feel it. I can feel it.
Is it arc behind you?
No.
Cool down for a bit.
Let's be able to pick it up and put the rollers in.
Yeah.
Piece of chalk out here?
There was.
There it is. 29 and a half.
Quarter inch.
That's a quarter inch off.
Yeah.
Wow, that's doing a nice job.
It picked it right up back here.
Oh, it's up?
Yeah.
All right, well then I don't need to go any down anymore. I don't think it's bending the pipe any. I think it's just lifting the lead.
Just tilt.
Can you put any more weight in it?
I can take the chains off and push the bar in there.
Nah, let's not do that. What if we set the bars on top of it?
You think it'll balance there? Yeah, it looks pretty sturdy.
Let me know when it comes up.
Right.
That's it, my chains are slack. Let me push it down 3/8 of an inch.
Okay.
That'll be all right.
It did move.
It needed to take a half inch out. 3/8 is better than nothing, ain't it? You know, somebody was saying that the mast could rake backwards, and that actually makes sense because the wind force pulls it forward more of the time than not.
Right.
So you're preloading it. Sounds very
Yeah,
it sounds very engineering like. So we put that, people believe that shit.
We gotta put that on camp.
Oh yeah, sure.
We gotta preload. We gotta leave the sail. We're gonna mount it so it's tilted back, so it looks like it's going faster.
You wanna fly?
Oh no, thanks. I probably got a cockroach in there.
At least. He's not swimming anymore. He must be resting.
He's taking a nap.
He's not wearing his PFD. That's the problem.
I hate to say it, but that's one of my best freaking passes yet.
Yeah, it is. You're doing that gap really well.
I just kept going, and I'm walking it.
Going across those gaps is hard to do.
Not one bowl out.
Better at that than I am. I'll let you finish the rest of them. Man, when that gap's right, that is just really easy to do.
Yeah. That's pretty.
And that purdy.
Oh, I like them first two.
Yeah, they're purdy down
there. Boy, them are nice. But the first two over here, boy, they are just nice, flat, symmetrical, full penetration.
Work on my consistency.
We're gonna try a filler rod. Yeah.
Down. Coming up.
Okay.
Okay, holding.
Now
you do much better with the hood.
That's more better with the hood. Yeah, I'm...
More?
grinder god is
the
here.
The grinder god is near.
How's that look?
That's mush.
Okay, we're no more than a quarter inch off on the top. And same thing at the midsection, we're about a quarter inch off. So we're gonna take down our beams and put our lead off to the side. Then we're not gonna be using it anymore and just start welding it. We got a lot of it done already, but we're gonna come back in here and start doing these fills, but we're still gonna move it around and do one side, then the other and check it some more. I just don't think we're gonna be pulling on it anymore. From up above, and it's easily within a half inch, probably within 3/8 of an inch. It's got some bumps and such in it, but we're very, very happy with that. See, about another day of welding and then a day of grinding, she'll be ready for the hot dip galvanizer. We got water bugs on top of our boat. Tells you how much it's been raining here. You can get down there and unplug it. Yeah, boat's taking a leak.
Just gotta cut it and try.
Yeah.
Start with the reference, that way we know we're referencing the same point every time we change something.
All right, if I go 25 off this
side. That's a little better.
What degree is that?
23.
That's about 23.
Yeah, you could.
Just a little bit more.
I don't know, guys. Yeah, do a little bit more, you'll 22. Be happier with it. But that's definitely usable.
That's good. So it's,
yeah, that's what we're gonna do.
That's
then.
What we want right there, right?
Yeah, that's it.
Is that square right there?
Yeah.
Okay. Beautiful.
What's the angle on that?
22.
About 22.
Right,
yeah.
22.
Shut up. Yeah.
Jack. Well, you got your angles cut and everything?
I think I got it, yeah.
So we need 25 of them.
Here's a cool idea. It's a piece of, what is this thing called? C-channel?
C-channel.
Yeah.
Angle iron center.
Yeah, angle iron would do it too, wouldn't it? And they get to mark the a straight line down the center of the pipe. That way they can line it up when they're cutting it so that both ends are cut at the same, with the same top. Yeah. All these parts that we're messing with this morning are for an aluminum gangway. Now that's the part that's going to go down this side of the boat on that catwalk.
Place for me to go fishing.
Yeah. And what we can do is we'll hinge it in the front up here, and it will pivot down into the water. It's 25 feet long. And so these are the cross pieces for it, and those other little pieces of, could have been flat bar, but they're just 2-inch square plates. They're gonna go between two of these pieces of pipe here. So four pieces of pipe, two on each side with those little spacers between them. And Dan Gramata, an engineer, came by and engineered this thing up for us. So all we gotta do is put it together and figure out the hinge. Too many people undersell happiness. Nothing wrong with being happy.
Well, that is pretty much right.
There is something wrong with being lazy, though.
Working too hard.
And letting me make your happiness for you.
No.
Shit,
I didn't see that.
don't think it's a big deal. I can bolt it up.
Before you go throwing underneath it again?
Oh, I know. I'm not in any motivation to get crushed.
I'm heading to me.
Yeah, those bearings are gone. Damaged it any? We'll see.
Camera.
Oh, good, cool.
Oh my God.
Chain lined up.
Yes, we made that little wheel right there for it. It was cast iron, we busted it, and that's all it needed. But the amazing part is getting the thing taken apart and put back together without breaking anything else.
I got the slow down on the thicker metal factor down.
What are the LS?
You don't want that way? Okay, make it that way. Is he picking up?
Yep.
Okay.
Well, I am, to say the least, extremely happy about the way that came out. I think we're a half inch out, and it's got the roughness down it that I expected, but it looks rounder than I thought it would, even here at the end, with half the material gone, so very pleased with it.
I need to say something to everybody out there on YouTube. When you watch these videos, and some of you have really appreciated the longer format. That's great. I'm glad you did, because it takes a lot of time to edit those things. But when you watch these videos, you get this distorted view that this takes 40 minutes to do. This takes days to do, and it takes long periods of running a grinder. This is hard-ass work, okay? So if you're thinking of coming, think about that first, all right? It's a lot of work. It's not all fun and games.
You gotta want to sweat.
Not everybody can have Jezebel's job of security. Jezebel, you're doing a great job. Yeah, you are. Well, thank you. Well, thank you very much.
3,500.
3,000. Oh, so we got 500 pounds extra, because that mast was 3,000 pounds before we tapered it.
Hurry, break.
The guy on the street says, good day. Nah, we're fine. Because the axles are way in the back there. Right. So even with the taper, we got more weight up here.
I missed it.